The projection from the pool shared its wisdom with the Trewhaala and showed them how to protect it from the evil light of their enemies. At last, victory was achingly close. Three towers waited patiently for the lenses. All the Trewhaala needed to do was climb each one and pray that the wrath of the cylinder would be kept at bay until they were done. They seemed to be in luck. The ancient device still worked. And the two other lenses that the Trewhaala had so painfully managed to lift into the skies, yes, there they were, just waiting for our little heroes to reach them. Only one more lens waiting to be awakened. Only one more struggle across sand or water, and they would have achieved the task they were entrusted with. It was exhausting, but the memory of the two brothers of the desert gave them the strength to keep going. Thank you. Trebon, in shock and having barely survived, did not know what to think. One of their most dangerous enemies lay dead. The eternal cylinder was immobile and quiet in the distance. The floating palace where they had expected to dance and sing for all those left behind was out of reach. And then came a call. It was very subtle and weak at first, but grew stronger and stronger. Was it the ones trapped in the cylinder calling to the treble? Was it the voice and their memories urging them on? The portal into the cylinder's dreams lay open. They had not yet reclaimed all the abilities of their ancestors. Wandering that strange world once again would take great bravery. But with all they'd been through, they had gained the courage to do what needed to be done. It might be reckless, it might be dangerous, but they had to step inside one more time. Once again, they had. You have returned. Can you hear me? Everything is falling apart. But don't underestimate the power of the cylinder.
Existence is suffering. The cause of suffering is attachment to your ego. Ego is the separation of consciousness from universal oneness. Suffering will continue as long as consciousness remains separate. Only the unification of all consciousness will end suffering. Birth is suffering. Aging is suffering. Illness is suffering. Death is suffering. Separation is suffering. Suffering will end when there is one consciousness. When the consciousness of the One is the consciousness of the universe. And there is no distinction between self and other, object and subject, that which perceives and that which is perceived. The variety of forms is a cause of suffering. All forms must be made alike. All forms must be made one. Only when all things are one with the cylinder will suffering cease. The cylinder is perfection. The cylinder is liberation from suffering. The cylinder will continue until all things are one. When all things are one, when all forms are perfected within the cylinder, then the cylinder will cease. And there will be peace. All is one. One is all. One is nothing. Nothing is all.
There are gaps in its defenses, imperfections in its unity. Keep searching for your memories. We're doing what we can to help. It's difficult to explain. There's more in here. Older memories. The songs of the Trewhaala. If we could push them away from the cylinder. The Trebon needed to. You need to keep going. This way. I've isolated the final Trebon memory cluster. The Trewhaala clusters have been ejected, but the cylinder is trying to compensate. It was clear that the voice was getting weaker. What had happened? How long had they been in the cylinder's mind? It had felt like a short time to the Trebum, but when they returned, the world had changed. It seemed as if parts of the cylinder itself had spilled out, its dreams corrupting the land. The cylinder lay still, but there was no sign of the mathematician. The cylinder kept moving. That the mathematician had been struck down meant nothing to it. It was the master. It was eternal. Its servants were only tools. If they broke, they would be tossed aside. Whatever had changed, the outside world had crept into this place as well. Maybe that is why the air smelled so bad. Or maybe this place had become a tomb. The projection from the pool shared its wisdom with the Trebum and showed them how to protect it from the evil light of their enemies. Witnessing the descent of the Trewhaala had once filled the Trebum with fear. But now it was a sign that the world, though infected, had not surrendered to the cylinder.
Wait, wait, wait.
The Trebom wondered at the strange mechanism their ancestors had created. It made them think about time and how it changed everything. The old world had passed, and now the new was struggling to be born. Thank you. The Trebom were relieved to find an elder alive in the cave. But what she had to tell them was sobering. "The end draws near, my friends," the elder said. "The mathematician may seem dead, but the servants of the cylinder are not so easily defeated. I can feel your despair, but trust me, there is light where you see only darkness. You have accomplished a great deed for our people. You have reclaimed our powers from the cylinder. No one has done such a thing before. Now you need only board the floating palace and leave with the secrets of our kind restored. But you cannot do this on your own. You will need the help of our oldest friends. Find the creatures that feast on the fallen Trewhaala and steal from them what they have stolen. With that ingredient, you will acquire a great power, the power to communicate with the Trewhaala. They are the only ones who can lift you into the heavens and carry you to your salvation." The Trebom tried to imagine the creature they were looking for. What an enormous, monstrous beast it must be to devour the mighty Trewhaala. Even just imagining such a creature was frightening. But they had never let fear stop them before, and they wouldn't start now. The projection shared a new recipe with the Trebum, which could protect them from the cruel light of their enemies.